Welcome to the 2019-20 CMHS All School Awards. We would like to welcome all of our family, community members, and friends to this award ceremony, even though it's online. We'd like to thank all of our teachers, our support staff, all of our staff here at Clatsop County Middle High School for supporting our students and family during this very difficult time this year. You're going to hear a number of different awards tonight. You're going to see a number of teachers celebrating students, and we know it's going to be a great night. I'd like to start out with our attendance awards. We have attendance of excellence, and we also have perfect attendance for this year, and we had a number of students. So our first award of the night goes to, for excellent attendance, Stormy Holmes, Alex Ray, Josh Baker, Michaela Hall, Morgan Martins, Cade Warren, Aiden Fink, Jessica Henry, Sadie Topp, Maddie Champion, Marquez Snyder, Ben Hadley, Daisha Holmes, Chloe McLeod, Hannah Shreve, Olivia Sprague, Michaela Sable, Caitlin Thomas, Jack Bergman, Dawson Gorley, Jordan Martins, Hayden McGinnis, Aaron Atkinson, Lily Booth, Isaac Bernard, Nick Callahan, Daniel Hahn, Michael Hartley, Lance St. Helens, Marcus Blaine, Zoa Culbertson, Abigail Garcia, Charles Lockridge Wheeler, Josh Ray, Lily Lever, Ethan Schmidt, Matthew Lee, Ethan Costin, Riley Norgren, Quentin Rigsby, Aaron Boyd, Jonathan Harris, Aaron Jones, Carter White, Crystal Castle, Tristan Strand, Summer Crepe, Emily Schmidt, Grace Tallman, Caitlin Sizemore, Annabelle Martin, Jason Miller, and our last of excellent attendance, again 98% or greater attendance, Brendan Scholl. Now for our students with perfect attendance, again 100% at school all the time, Aiden Gear, Chloe May, Angelica Todd, Emma Lester, Elena McMillan, Cameron Rolls, Dominique Gordon, Gabe Raber, Stephen Hartley, Alex Schmidt, Blake Brockway, Gina Limone, and Ryan Smith. Thank you for all of those students who put attendance at the forefront of their goals here at Clatsop Middle High School. And now on to our next award.
Y'all already know it's the AP.
Six figures I was only for. Six figures I was only for.
It's now that time of year to transition from this year's student body officers to next year's. You may notice that some of the outgoing officers have left some advice for their successors. Please give some recognition to your ASB officers. The 2020-2021 Tech Director will be Hayden McGinnis. Grace Tallman will continue to serve as your Student Body Service Coordinator, but would like to welcome next year's Spirit Coordinator, Ethan Baker.
Hello, everyone. I have had the privilege of being ASB Service Coordinator this year, and I'm excited to take on the role again next year. As service coordinator, I am in charge of planning all of the service events such as the Canned Food Drive and Dornbecker Week. I am also doing this video today to announce the transition of our ASB Spirit Coordinator. Sadly, our previous spirit coordinator moved away, so I was given the opportunity to announce the transition for them. As spirit coordinator, it is your job to get the school hyped up for events, or basically just raise school spirit. I know that our incoming spirit coordinator, Ethan Baker, will do an amazing job at this. He is always full of school spirit and is passionate about getting students more involved. As my spirit coordinator gift to you, Ethan, I have made a really fancy paper crown. The ASB role you are about to take will make you the king of spirit at Clatskanie Middle High School, and I felt like this crown could represent that. I am looking forward to another great year at CMHS. Thank you.
Andrea Rodas will be handing off the duties of the publicity officer to Natalie Gray.
Hi, everybody. So I'm Andrea Rodas, and I am your 2019-2020 publicity officer. But now it is time to give up the position to the amazing Natalie Gray. So I have two things that I want to give to you, obviously when I'm able to see you. So the first one being this waterproof bag just to take the best pictures underwater. And also these headphones, because being involved with technology will involve a lot of listening to music, and I want you to have something so that you can listen to music even better. I know that you will be an amazing publicity officer, and don't forget to enjoy this position because it is very creative and very fun. So enjoy.
Emma Lieber will continue to serve as your student body secretary. Your current ASB Vice President, Kaylee Bowler, would like to welcome next year's Vice President, Lily Booth.
The position of ASB Vice President is an important one, and frankly, sometimes challenging. You're in charge of homecoming and homegoing week, along with other daily tasks. So for your transition gift, I got you a journal to write down all of your incredible ideas, and I also made you a little crown because you're in charge of homecoming week, and you being able to survive that gives you queen status. You're going to do amazing things as Vice President, Lily.
Lily Booth also has a transition message for her successor as the junior class president, Riley Norgren.
Hey, so I'm going to be talking about your gift really quick. So I got you a notebook because I like taking notes. And on the inside it says, remember who you are, what you are, and who you represent, and then a little OASC. Because I really think it's important to have a daily reminder like that and remember what you're doing and why you're doing it. So I also got you this pen, and it's just a standard notebook where you can write down ideas and you can write down everything you need just to stay organized and to remember what you're doing and why you're doing it. So, bye.
And last but not least, this year's student body president, Jackson Booth, would like to introduce your new student body president for 2020-2021, Kaylee Bowler.
Hi, Kaylee. I'm here to walk you through the gifts I got you for our transitions. So I'm going to start off. I got you a reporter's notebook. So I got you a reporter's notebook because, you know, it's nice and small, so you don't have to lug it around, you know, just fit anywhere in your backpack pretty much. And I got it for you because I wasn't very organized this year, and I wish I was more organized because I wasn't all 4 years, and I still worked on it. But so you can keep meeting notes or any little ideas that pop in your head. I also got you it because I think it's a great opportunity for you to write down any memories that you can think of that you like late at night, you're sitting around the house and you just think of something that went on today that made you laugh or made you smile in the hallway. You write it down, and then at the end of the year you'll have a full notebook of memories that, you know, are good to look back on when you leave class tonight. Next I got you some nice colorful pens. You know, I got you those because I think it's very, very important to be creative in this one. Like I said in my Google Doc that you'll get pretty soon, a lot of things can get tedious sometimes. I mean, that's with anything though. Especially school, it can get tedious. So you need to find ways to make it not tedious, you know, make it not boring, like get people engaged. You know, so you have to be creative, and sometimes all that takes is a little color, you know. I mean, that's basically all I got. I know you're going to do a great job. I can't wait to hear what you're going to do next year, and I think it's going to be an amazing school year for you guys.
two, three, four.
I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man.
Greetings. This next award goes to the most outstanding performance in advanced biology this year, most scientific, most professional, helping out other students that didn't understand, set up an incredible ecosystem for shrimp that is breeding and thriving. Most outstanding advanced biology student this year goes to Hannah Shreve. Hello. This next award is for the two students that were most outstanding in biology class this year. Exceptional work ethic, professionalism, intelligence, great classmates. And the best we had to offer in biology this year was performed by Emma Lever and Keegan Halsey. Congratulations. Hello, this next award is for the outstanding achievement and effort and sportsmanship in middle school PE. I had two people that were always prepared, ready to go, great classmates, gave their best effort, and the award for awesome middle school PE superstars goes to Topher McDonald and Jack Bergman. Congratulations.
Long live the walls that crash through all the kingdom.
Garlock here. I wanted to pop on and let you know who's receiving the math awards for my classes this year. So for Algebra 1, the most outstanding Algebra 1 student is Jordan Martins. For Geometry, the most outstanding Geometry student is Hannah Shreve. And for my fifth period pre-calc, the most outstanding pre-calc student is Josh Ray. So congrats to you three. Awesome job. And to everyone, thank you so much for being so wonderful during this time of distance learning. And I'm really proud of your hard work and how flexible you all were. For my college classes, my calculus and pre-calculus, you guys will be receiving a certificate as well that says that you received 8 college credits that will be awaiting you upon your graduation. So great job to everyone. Just thank you so much, and I hope you have a wonderful summer.
Rise up. If you're living on your knees, you rise up.
Hey guys, what's up? Mrs. Irwin here with middle school awards. So my middle schoolers, super proud of you. We're going to start with middle school choir. And we're starting with, I have 4 outstanding middle school choir students who are getting awesome certificates. And those students are Zoa Culbertson, Estella Hamilton, Abigail Garcia, and Xander. Congratulations, guys. You guys kicked it and killed it in middle school choir. Next up, we had 5 middle schoolers in the high school band, which is quite the task. All right. So the first 2 awards are going to go to most improved. This guy, just night and day from when he came into the class. He worked really hard and just did a really awesome job. So Jordan Isaacson, most improved. Awesome job, bud. The next person kind of hit or miss, started out kind of rocky, but you know what? She stuck with it and she really started picking up speed, and I'm so proud of her for sticking with it, and her sound improved and she was just amazing by the end of this. Brenna Yellen, most improved. Nice job, Brenna. Then I have 3 outstanding. These guys just went from here to here. They all participated, or most of them participated in honor band, which is a big feat in itself. So for arts outstanding band students, 8th graders in the high school band, Megan Krecka, Zoa Culbertson, and Jake Anderson. Nice job, guys. And my last middle school awards go to the boy band. They know who they are, middle school band. So first up, We have the best addition. This guy took a break for a year and then came back to band, and we were so glad to have him. Brendan Scholl, best addition in the boy band, middle school band. Next up, this guy has improved so much over the years. And he went from like a 5 to a 10, and he's just killing it. He's just doing a great job on that trombone. Most improved, Aaron Hadley. Nice job, buddy. This one, the dedication award. Dedication to me means hardworking, going over and beyond, asking questions. He did summer lessons with me last summer, and it totally showed. So the dedication award for middle school band goes to Aiden Finke. Nice job, Aiden. And last but not least, for middle school awards, outstanding in middle school band and the boy band. This guy has just got skills, just so many skills. And that guy is Jason Miller. Nice job, guys. We'll see you next year. All right, guys, up next are high school awards. So we're going to start with drama. And drama was one of those years where it's like everybody could get an award. And so I decided to pick one person to get the director's award. And this person helps behind the scenes. They help their friends. They help each other. This is the first time that they were taking on a role. They usually just do the backstage gig. So super proud of this person and kind of being my right-hand person all through this year. So the director's award for high school drama goes to Ronnie Price. Yay, Ronnie! Nice job! Moving on, we're going to do some different art awards separately, but there's one art award that I want to award now, and it's actually for art and for choir, and that's the Enthusiasm Award, and that enthusiasm person is Mr. Josh Blazer! Nice job, Josh! Up next, choir. I have two most improved awards. This guy is always just so helpful, and he is just really wanting to sing all the time and does the best that he can, and I saw him improve so much this year. So most improved, Glenn Sims. Nice job, buddy. This person started, she's been singing for a really long time, and I just saw her go and just improve so much this year. So Kelsey Hill, most improved this year. Nice job. We have our Outstanding Freshman Award, which actually the freshman pool is actually pretty big in this class. There's a lot of freshmen in this class, and one person stood out a little bit more than the others. Just really, really dedicated, beautiful voice, always willing to help, just going over and beyond. And that's really what deserves this award. And that person is Outstanding Freshman Satari White Anderson. Nice job. We have an Outstanding Junior Award. This person received the Director's Award last year and could have received that award this year because that's who she is. But she just went over and above for a class, taking control when she needed to, helping others when she needed to. Of course, a beautiful voice. So Outstanding Junior, Lily Booth. Nice job, Lily. Our last award for choir. This is the big award. This is the National Choir Award. It's a national award. You have to be of a certain caliber to even kind of register for it. We've had some years where nobody's really qualified for it. But this person, over and above, beautiful, beautiful voice. Hands down, just voice of an angel. Okay, we all know it. We hear it. We love it. So this year, National Honor Choir Award goes to Macy Newton. Nice job, Macy. All right, on to our band awards for high school band, symphonic band. We have Outstanding Freshman. Again, this person goes over and beyond, is at every event, doing the best she can, helping others, and is just right over there. And that person is, again, Satari White Anderson. Nice job. This person, okay, they are only sophomore, but that's not why they got this award. Okay, they would have gotten this award regardless because this person has improved a lot. I told her at the beginning of the year, this is her year to take charge and to play that trumpet and to do that thing. And she did. She killed it. And Outstanding Sophomore goes to Michaela Hall. Nice job, Michaela. Our Outstanding Junior, this guy is just, he's just on it, man. He just does everything he's supposed to do and has a great trumpet sound. He leads things. He makes sure that things are going good. And Outstanding Junior, Josh Ray. Good job, Josh. Thanks, bud. And last but not least, the big award. Oh, actually, just kidding. Gabe Caton got the director's award for being a senior. He already got it. We did senior awards already. So he got the director's award for helping us and being our band president. So now the last award goes to, this is the national award. This is the John Philip Sousa Award. If you guys know, those of you who don't know who John Philip Sousa is, kind of a big guy in the music land, especially in the band land. So this is a national award. You have to be of a certain caliber to even qualify for this award. This guy plays trumpet, clarinet, baritone, guitar, and he sings. So, and he does all of those really well. So this puts him over and above. So this year's national award goes to Blake Brockway. Woo! Nice job, Blake. All right, that wraps up our music drama awards, and we'll do some art awards here soon. All right, guys, the last awards are the art awards. So me and Miss Jessie talked about what we really thought was important. And the first award is the most improved award. To this person who started out very much like, I can't do this, I don't want to do this, this looks awful. And we kept encouraging her and said, hey, you can do this. And by the end, it was a, hey, look what I did. I've done amazing work. And you did do amazing work and you stuck with it. So Kiana Crawford, congratulations, most improved artist. The next award goes to somebody who has a really strong aesthetic. You can definitely tell it's his piece of art. He has found his voice through his artistic works. So the Individualism Award goes to David Noland. And the last art award goes to somebody who puts in 150,000,000% in everything she does a great job, has a smile while doing it, has a smile while helping others, is always just so much fun to have in class. And her artwork is amazing, and her personality is amazing, and she's just all around amazing. So the 110% award goes to Miss Maya Hellman, aka Sparkle Kitty.
Tigers, what's up? I am here for high school social studies, and I'm also here to present National Honor Society awards for students who were selected into National Honor Society. So I'm going to start off with that. So we had a group of faculty members that met recently and selected a group of members based on excellent scholarship, character, leadership, and service in their community. And I'd like to take a moment right now to recognize them. So our new NHS members for next year are as follows. Keegan Halsey, Emma Lever, Andrea Rodas, Grace Tallman, Stephen Hartley, Danielle Hewitt, Aaron Adkinson, and Riley Norgren. So congratulations to all of you for being accepted into the National Honor Society. For my classroom awards, I teach three classes. I teach World Geography, U.S. History, and Government. I'm going to start off with World Geography. World Geography, this is called the World Traveler Award. And this is for students who basically work really hard every day in class. They're attentive. They turn everything in. They participate really well. So our two awardees for World Traveler Award go to Hayden McGinnis. Congratulations, Hayden. And Maya Hellman. Congratulations, Maya. Excellent work. For U.S. History, we have the Time Traveler Award. The Time Traveler Award goes out to people that are outstanding students in U.S. History. I've got two awardees for this one as well. They work really hard every day. They communicate really well. And I think that they just put in a lot of effort this year. So the first one goes to Beatriz Rojas Batista. Congratulations, Beatriz. And our second award, Time Travel Award, goes to Ashley Lankert. Congratulations, Ashley. Nice job. And finally, for Government, which is our seniors, our Government Award. I have one award. This goes to somebody who's always willing to participate
always raised his hands with excellent points. He was always willing to go up in front of the class, was never afraid or never shy to do that. And one day in the future, he will make an excellent Speaker of the House of Representatives, and that goes to Aaron Boyd. Congratulations, Aaron. Congratulations on all of our social studies winners and our NHS members.
The first awards I have are for students who have shown an unwavering dedication to showing up to class and actively participating to the very end. For those of you who signed on with cameras off and mics muted, I get it. But these people went above and beyond to stay connected in their classes. These awards go to Satari White Anderson, Peter Lovegren, and Kaylee Bowler. Next, I have four students in the English 1 class who kept class discussions progressing in the awkward Zoom environment that we all had to adopt. Thanks to them, when I threw out questions into the silent abyss of a Zoom classroom, these individuals would bail me out and restore my faith that at least some of my students were still breathing on the other end. These awards go to Maddie Champion, Jamin Erickson, Stormy Holmes, and Maya Hellman. In English 3, students participated in a debate tournament. I was thoroughly impressed with all of the students this year, as they generally came well-prepared, were great at supporting teammates with last-minute research and insight, and executed some thoughtful and lively arguments. While there were many students who could fall into the MVP category, there were two that stood out the most. One for his relentless barrage of information and academic vocabulary, whom I began dubbing the professor, and the other for her fiery and intimidating delivery of rebuttals and facts. These two students, who are the debate masters of the year, are Josh Ray and Shelby Blodgett. In English 1, I have three students who stood out and are receiving an Academic Excellence Award. They were receiving this award for their hard work, self-initiative, and mastery of the language arts materials. These students are Joss Pember, Jordan Martins, and Alex Ray. Receiving Academic Excellence in English 3 are two students who stood out in a very competitive field. There are at least a dozen other students who could have earned this award, but these two show a sincere interest in analyzing and learning materials. I am under no illusions that all of my students share the same passion and love for language arts as I do, but it is refreshing to meet those that do, or at least are willing to hold quality discussions about it. Those two students are Hannah Shreve and Stephen Hartley. My last two English awards are for two individuals who took hold of distance learning as a way of making a comeback. Both students worked hard to check in, communicate, and complete their work. These awards go to Austin Hahn and Blake Brockway. My final award is for a leadership student. This is the hardest award to choose every year, as there are at least a dozen students very dedicated to trying to make our school a great place to be. I want to give a shout out to those who have stuck through it this year and have continued to make contributions and show up to meetings during this time. Ashley, Kaylee, Lily, Jack, Anna, Trinity, Emma, Riley, Andrea, Grace, Megan, Trinity Sweden, Evan, Jeffrey, Cecilia, Kalani, Jordan, and Topher. I apologize if I left anyone out. Amidst all that dedication and extra time that these people put in, there is one person who did just a teeny bit more. This year, the award for excellence in leadership goes to Grace Tallman. It's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll. It's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll.
Good evening. I have been forced to give the Teacher's Pet Award. I do this under protest because many eighth graders demand it be given. They have demanded it be given to the one who rightly deserves it. So therefore, the 2020 Teacher's Pet Award goes to Topher. His peers recognize his work ethic, his great answers to questions, and his leadership quality in serving others. I did not want to give this award because everybody knows this. Why state the obvious? So, Topher, because your peers recognize your fine qualities, why I give you this highly esteemed honor of the Teacher's Pet Award. Congratulations.
This wasn't our normal school year. We were all faced with some challenges, and I know I was with technology being the main challenge. A lot of things I learned along the way, and then we come across that part of the school year where that just snuck up on me about the awards, and it's really hard for me to choose like specific people because I think we all stood out in our own way, and we're all growing. But I did find five people that I wanted to mention especially, and then I have a message for them. So, Brendan Schroll, Topher McDonald, Michael Hartley, Lilia Lever, Zoa Culbertson, Jessica Henry, and Jason Miller. Here is my message to you. Thank you for taking chances, seeking answers, trying to be better, wanting to be challenged, and being okay with the reality that you will most likely be making errors along the way during those challenges. The courage and discipline it takes for you to take chances and not be afraid of making errors is, in my opinion, what success really is. Successful people in the world, you think of anyone that you consider successful, chances are they have made a lot of errors along the way. But they learned from them, they got better, and that's what we remember them for. I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got a love and I know that it's all mine. Oh, whoa.
Do what you want, but you're never gonna break me. Stick some stones in there. Hey everyone, it's the Middle School ELA Awards. Couldn't let the year get by without finishing off appreciating those special students that help make our days brighter. First up, Good Friend Award. We have seventh grader Brendan Schroll. And another seventh grader Good Friend Award, Roman Weaver. And Crystal Castle, the other Good Friend Award. The next category is Ravenous Reader. We have three this year. First is seventh grader Ethan Schmidt. And another seventh grader, Joseph Woodard.
Our last ravenous reader is a new student, Kylie Rose. Please look up Kylie. She's an eighth grader and loves to read.
The next category is new this year because we have a very talented, outstanding origamist. Josiah is very skilled in origami and loved to share it with our art class. Very much appreciated.
And again, in the new category, what would this pandemic have been without the Dedicated Distance Learner Award? First up is Tristan Strand. He also is a new student with Kylie Rose. And no pictures are available at this time, but please reach out and make sure to congratulate both Tristan and Kylie. Tristan did an amazing job of balancing paper packets and electronics. Our second dedicated distance learner is Lance St. Helens. He managed to make it to all of our online classes even while traveling. And our last dedicated distance learner award goes to Aaron Jones. Researching topics of interest and making sure to bring it all those facts and data to our online classes. Our very last award is the Golden Pen Award. Usually these are reserved for the eighth graders, but this year we have two eighth graders and one seventh grader. The Golden Pen Awards are for writing with heart and soul. Zoa is in eighth grade and she is joined by Brenna Yellen. As I said, the Golden Pen Award is usually with eighth graders, but this year we do have one more outstanding writing student that takes heart and soul with her craft. And that is Miss Lilia Lieber.
Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Here's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. All right.
Miss that one. Nina, go ahead and edit that one out if you want. There it is. What's up, guys? Here today to present the PE Awards. This year, PE Awards for outstanding effort, attitude, working hard every day, getting it done. We're going to throw it to Keegan Halsey, Jordan Martins. Nice job, guys. Appreciate you guys doing what you got to do. Now I'm gonna throw it to the next guy. Oh, sorry about that. Hey guys, I'm here today to talk to you and present the awards for Best Health Student. I got a bunch of them, so you're gonna have to bear with me. This award goes to four young ladies that worked their butts off this year, best of the best grade in the class, showed up every day, health notebooks, they got it all, making it happen. So I wanna throw it out to Riley Norgren, Grace Tallman, Emma Lever, and Andrea Rodas, making it happen. Nice job, girls. Health Award 2020. Now I'm gonna throw it to the next guy. Oh, yeah. Oh, hey guys. This next award goes to the best weight trainer. I call this the Getting Ripped Award. Oh yeah. This award, I'm going to give a shout out to a couple seniors, even though they're not here anymore. They got it done. Oh, it was incredible. So here we got Dawson Evenson, Isabella Cueto. Incredible. Working their tails off every day, no matter what. I also had one other young man I want to give it out to. Big Tone Cueto. Also, family affair, Isabella Big Tone. Awesome job. Incredible. 2020, Getting Ripped Award. Oh, yeah.
For Sizemore's 2019-20 year-end awards. We're going to start with the Golden Pen Award, which is excellence in writing for my classes. So the Golden Pen Award for 100. The winner for English 2 second first period is Lake McMaster. Woo! Hey, let's see the Golden Pen Award for 200. And the winner for second period college English is Trinity Ham. Woohoo! Hey, Mr. Watermelon, let's see the Golden Pen Award for 300. And the winner for third period English 2 is Michaela Hall. Yay! Whoa, the crowd goes wild. And our Golden Pen Award for sixth period English is, this would be our seniors, Jordan Maddox. All right, let's continue. And our Golden Pen Award for 500. The winner for journalism is Hannah Gibbons. Moving on to our next category, that would be the Mohandas Gandhi Award. This is for excellence in leadership. Now, I could have given it to everybody this year in middle school leadership. However, I had to pick my top five. So our first winner is Topher McDonald. Let's go for 200. Our second winner is Nikoya Osmus. Our third winner is, drum roll please, JD McLeod. Our fourth winner is Estella Hamilton. Yay, Estella. And last but not least, our fifth winner is Jason Miller. Congratulations, guys. Now, our Webster Award, this is for excellence in vocabulary. Vocabulary is huge in language arts. And after the great Daniel Webster, our first period winner is Caleb Bostick. And our college English winner is Jonathan Morvis. Our third period winner is Emily Schmidt. And last but not least, our seniors for sixth period, our winner is Trent Bernstein. Now, we use vocab all the time in middle school leadership, so I decided to give that award this year. For Ethan Schmidt, the walking dictionary. This kid's got a great vocab. Keep an eye out for him in the future. So the Bill Gates Award is for excellence in technology. So for our middle school computer apps class, for the cruise classes, our first winner is Cameron Putnam. Yay, Cameron! And let's see who our second winner is. Dragon Holmes. Now this kid can build a robot, let me tell you. Our third winner is Arabella Isaacson. Now, this girl is a graphic artist like no other. Our fourth winner is, drum roll please, dun 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 dun, Jack Bergman. This kid is amazing. Our fifth winner is Evan Lean. This kid can do some wonderful stuff on the computer. Now, we do a lot of discussions, particularly over novel units and the things that we read. And so the Socrates Award for first period goes to Matthew Hines and Kiana Crawford. These two, I couldn't decide. It was a tie. They contribute so much to our class discussions. It's amazing. For college English, Gabe Caton and Anya Hamilton. Do not get in a debate with these two, let me tell you. And for third period English 2, we have Andrea Rodas. This girl has all kinds of thoughts, so watch out. For sixth period, singing English, we have Nick Callahan. Now this boy, he likes to be quiet on the down low, but let me tell you, get him in a good argument and he can just roll right over the top of you. And last but not least, for middle school leadership, our Socrates Award goes to Roman Weaver. Whoa! Our last category is the Winston Churchill Award. This is for great oratory skills in the area of language arts and leadership this year. Our winner for first period English 2 is Keegan Halsey. This boy can speak. All right, for college English, the winner that we've all been waiting for, the man that you want to get to speak on anything, is Reese Newton. Fabulous speaker. Fabulous. All right, for third period, English 2, we have Trinity Sweden. Woohoo! For our senior English 6th period, the Winston Churchill Award goes to Aaron Boyd. This is another eloquent speaker, ladies and gentlemen, so keep your eyes out for him in the future. And last but not least, for middle school leadership, our Winston Churchill Award goes to Bailey Lichty. She can stand up and she can deliver a speech like none other. That is the end of my awards for Sizemore's school year.
To fight, to conquer, to thrive, I came to win, to survive.